Good morning everyone. In this video, we are going to cover the current affairs. For mobile optimized ebooks, please install GKToday Academy app. For regular updates, please join our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. We have started a new channel, Civils Academy. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. Now, let's start. Which is the knowledge partner of Microsoft for the India edition of Amazon Cup 2021? So, NSDC is a knowledge partner of Microsoft for this Amazon Cup 2021. This Amazon Cup is innovation challenge organized by Microsoft. What is NSDC? It is National Skill Development Corporation. Recently, Microsoft and NSDC collaborated to empower 1 lakh women with digital skills. Microsoft was also in news as it partnered with AICTE to empower the students and to empower the educators. What is AICTE? It is All India Council for Technical Education. So it is under MHRD, that is Ministry of Human Resource Development. MHRD is now renamed as MOE, that is Ministry of Education. Recently, this AICTE was also in news because of TULIP scheme. Answer in comment box, what is TULIP scheme and what is the core objective of this initiative? The Supreme Court has upheld that GST, that is Goods and Service Tax, shall be imposed on which type of goods referring as actionable claims. So, it is about lottery. So, recently, Supreme Court upheld that GST shall be imposed on the sale of lotteries, betting and on gambling. Now, recently, this GST was also in news because of GST compensation issue. So, there was a shortfall in revenue collection and to compensate that shortfall in GST revenue collection, central government proposed two options. First option was that states can borrow 1.1 lakh crore out of estimated shortfall of 2.3 lakh crore. So this was the total shortfall, including because of GST and because of Corona. So first option was that states can borrow this 1.1 lakh crore. Second option was that states can borrow entire amount. So now, all the states and union territories have opted for this first option. Now, when I say all the states and union territories, it means only those union territories which have legislative assembly. So, all 28 states and 3 union territories have opted for this first option. And Jharkhand was the last state to accept this offer. The CLMV countries are the group of countries belonging to which regional organization? So, it is related to ASEAN. What is ASEAN? It is Association of Southeast Asian Nation. What is CLMV? It is Cambodia, Laos, Myanmar and Vietnam. So, all these 4 countries are part of ASEAN. ASEAN is a grouping of 10 countries. That is BPLTV MMICS. For this year, Vietnam is the chair of ASEAN. Now, recently the CLMV was in news because of 6th India CLMV business conclave was organized. Recently, ASEAN was in news because ASEAN members plus 5 other countries signed RCEP, that is Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So, China is a part of this trade agreement and India is not a part. Apart from this CLMV, there is another cooperation group and it is Mekong Ganga Cooperation. So, it is a cooperation between India and these CLMV countries plus Thailand. In fact, ASEAN was established through Bangkok Declaration. Bangkok is the capital of Thailand. What is the new limit of transaction made using contactless card as per the recent statement of RBI, that is Reserve Bank of India? So, the new limit is 5,000. Previous limit was 2,000. And this is going to be effective from 1st of January in 2021. So, this is for contactless card. RBI also increased the limit for recurring transactions using card and using UPI. So, the new limit is 5,000. What is the meaning of this term recurring transactions? For example, you pay your electricity bill on a regular basis. So, these are frequent transactions. Recently, RBI was also in news because of its monetary policy. So, as per recent monetary policy statement, repo rate is 4%, reverse repo is 3.3 3.5%, and MSF, that is marginal standing facility, and bank rate is 4.25%. So these are LAF, that is liquidity adjustment facility. Which country has announced to establish friendship association with India to strengthen its ties? So this is Oman. It is a West Asian country, and it is a first of its kind initiative in the West Asia, which is led by the foreign ministry. So to strengthen the relationship between India and Oman, both countries will set up this friendship association. Oman is in West Asia, capital is Muscat, and currency is Omani Rial. Where is the headquarters of United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs? So the headquarters is in Vienna. Recently, the meeting of this United Nations Commission on Narcotic Drugs was organized. And during that meeting, 53 countries, including India, voted for removing cannabis from the Schedule 4 of this 1961 Single Convention on Narcotic Drugs. Right now, that means before this voting, it was listed as deadly and addictive drug. But these 53 countries, including India, voted that it should be removed from this list. That means it should be removed from the list of deadly and addictive drugs. In India, we have NCB, that is Narcotics Control Bureau. And this NCB is under MHA, that is Ministry of Home Affairs. NCB is responsible for the controlling drug menace in our country. And it is main authority for the implementation of NDPS Act. NDPS stands for Narcotics, Drug and Psychotropic Substances. DCOAS strategy is a new post to be created in which Indian Armed Force. So it is related to Indian Army. What is the full form of DCOAS? It is Deputy Chief of Army Staff. So this new post has been announced by the government, and this will be created in Indian Army. And this post, that is DCOAS, will be responsible to oversee the work of DGMO and DGMI. Now DGMO stands for Director General of Military Operations. DGMI stands for Director General of Military Intelligence. So these two entities will be under DCOAS. Right now they report to Vice Chief of Army Staff. So this is new structural change which has been announced. Now every year on 15th of January, Army Day is celebrated. Recently Navy Day was celebrated on 4th of December. Lesser Florican birds tagged in which Indian state has flown to Telangana recently? So these birds were tagged by the Gujarat Forest Department. What is the meaning of this term tagged? So a geotagging device is attached on the body of the bird so that the movement can be tracked. So it will help in tracking the movement of that specific bird. Now recently Gujarat was in news as Gujarat High Court became the first high court in our country to live stream the proceedings on YouTube. Gujarat was also in news as recently Gujarat government announced that it is going to set up world's biggest zinc smelter project. Where is the National Institute of Naturopathy located? So this institute is in Pune in Maharashtra. Now why this institute was in news recently? The present building of this National Institute of Naturopathy is known as Bapu Bhavan. Recently, Ayush Ministry proposed that a new campus of this National Institute of Naturopathy should be named as Nisarg Gram. So that is why it was in news. Now recently Maharashtra was in news because of Lonar Lake. It was also in news because of Buldhana pattern. It was also in news because of My Family, My Responsibility campaign. The 3D object creation platform named Poly is operated by which technology major? So it is operated by Google, and recently it was in news because Google has proposed to shut down this platform from next year. Recently Google was also in news as it collaborated with CWC, that is Central Water Commission, for the flood forecast. Google was also in news as recently it renamed and relaunched Google Plus as Google Currents. So it has been relaunched as Google Currents. Prakash Singh Badal is the former Chief Minister of which state? So he is the former Chief Minister of Punjab. Why he was in news recently? Because he returned his Padma Vibhushan Award in the support of farmers' protest. And he is the leader of SAD, that is Shiromani Akali Dal. Recently, this party left NDA. NDA is National Democratic Alliance. So, it is the alliance of political parties and the major party is BJP. So, SAD left NDA and at that point of time, Harsimrat Kaur Badal from SAD also resigned. She was the Minister of Food Processing and Industries. Later, that portfolio was given to Narendra Singh Tomar. Mr. Tomar is our present Agriculture Minister as well. His constituency is Morena. It is in Madhya Pradesh. Recently, Madhya Pradesh decided to set up a cow cabinet. As per the recent study by ZSI, that is Geological Survey of India, which type of squirrel is on the verge of extinction? So, it is Malayan giant squirrel. So, recently ZSI conducted a first of its kind study and as per it, this Malayan giant squirrel could decline by 90% in India by 2050. And if proper steps are not taken, then it may become extinct in our country. Now, this ZSI, that is Geological Survey of India, is under Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Headquarters is in Kolkata. It is in West Bengal. Recently, West Bengal was in news because India's first tire park is set up in West Bengal. Apart from that, world's first tram library is also set up in West Bengal. So, these were the most important questions. Now, we are going to cover important news. So, first is United Nations Investment Promotion Award. So, this award was given to Invest India and this has been given by UNCTAD. What is UNCTAD? It is United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Next is Recover with Integrity. So, every year on 9th of December, this International Anti-Corruption Day was observed and this year the theme was Recover with Integrity. Next is WHO Foundation. So, recently Anil Soni became the new CEO of this WHO Foundation. Anil Soni is of Indian origin and he is a well-known health expert. Next is Formula 2 race. So, recently Jehan Daruwala created history as he became first Indian to win this Formula 2 race at Sakhir Grand Prix in Bahrain. And Sergio Prej won the 2020 Sakhir Grand Prix. Next is Rabindranath Tagore Literary Prize. So, Raj Kamal Jha was selected for this prize and he was selected for his novel The City and the Sea. Next is QRMP scheme. So, it is related to GST, that is Goods and Service Tax. Recently, central government announced the scheme for the small taxpayers whose annual aggregate turnover is up to 5 crore rupees. So, what is this QRMP? It is quarterly return and monthly payment of taxes. So, the full form is self-explanatory. Next is breakdance. So, in 2024 Olympic Games, breakdance will be the part of Olympic. And these Olympic Games will be organized in Paris. So, breakdancing will be the first dance sport event to appear at Olympic Games. Next is International King Bhumibol World Soil Day Award. So, this award was given to ICAR, that is Indian Council of Agriculture Research. And this was given on the occasion of World Soil Day. And this award has been presented by FAO, that is Food and Agriculture Organization. World Soil Day is on 5th of December. Next is India's first diversified REIT mutual fund. Now, what is this REIT? It stands for Real Estate Investment Fund. So, Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company has launched India's first diversified REIT mutual fund. Next is World Economic Forum. So, usually this is organized in Davos, but this time, that means in 2021, it will be organized in Singapore. Next is Asia Cup. So, it is a cricket tournament and next year, it will be organized by Sri Lanka. And in 2022, it will be organized by Pakistan. Next is iMobile Pay. So, this has been launched by ICICI Bank. It is a mobile payment app. Next is 100% organic. So, Sikkim is the first state in our country to be 100% organic. And now, Lakshadweep is the first union territory to become 100% organic. Next is Central Jew Authority. So, recently, Central Jew Authority granted recognition to new zoo. One is Rajgir Zoo Safari in Nalanda, so it is in Bihar. And another one is Shahid Ashfaqullah Khan Prani Udyan, and it is in Gorakhpur in Uttar Pradesh. So recently Central Zoo Authority gave recognition these two new zoo. Next is Eco Duct or Eco Bridge. So recently Ramnagar Forest Division built its first eco bridge, and this is for reptiles and mammals. Now what is the meaning of this term eco bridge or eco duct? Suppose there's one ecological area and this is another ecological area. Now reptiles or the mammals will be able to visit these two areas with the help of this eco duct. That means it is a connective path that will provide access to these areas without human intervention. Next is Madhukar Gangadhar. So he was the writer of AIR, that is All India Radio. He was a prominent Hindi writer. He passed away recently. So these were the most important events. Now homework. So please read about Havana syndrome and LIDAR. So that was all for the day. Thank you.